cricket, Jack Bannister.
Closing in on 700, 682 for six. Bresnan, he's on 36, and he and Cook, who's been there since the very first ball was bowled, obviously he's on 283. They've put on 69 so far. The lead is 458. And I still think that England either could or certainly, if not should, they could declare by round about half 5:46. And if the weather holds, rain forecast for a bit later on, just after a nasty 45 minutes of this Indian side that must be absolutely shattered mentally and physically. 682 for six, they lead by 458.
Morning. Just let me make it clear now, I haven't come on to take a view either way about whether he should or shouldn't be playing, but the, what went on in the drive programme yesterday, from Goffey in particular, and to a lesser degree Adrian, was just they kept peddling two things which were factually incorrect.
Lucius, he say man who has hands in pockets feels cocky all day. Anyone for Frankenstein? He's the man who got out first ball he faced this morning, caught by Swan. And his first ball was 81 miles an hour. His second ball, after he'd got that out of the way, was 88. He looks the quickest of the lot, and he looks quite sharp. But at the moment, Cook on 24 and Strauss on 11. No real alarms, and England 40 for no wicket.
What would be a good day for England, Jack?
Yeah, I think so. This pitch, which traditionally at Lord's, especially in May and after all the dampness we've had, dampness not on top. Mike Hunt, the groundsman, he's done a very good job indeed. Dry on top, but there's moisture underneath. Day one, it moved about and swung a little bit. Day two, this afternoon and tomorrow, it's the best for batting, and England will be looking.
Jack, good morning.
Morning, Jack.
Morning to you both. And England going on extremely well. The 300's up, 302 for one. Cook is on 171, and to add to all his other records, youngest to get 7,000 runs, etc., and he's the only batsman ever to score 700s in India. 700s, if you please. A lot have got six, and some of the great players, left-handers, Border and Brian Lara and so on and so forth, but he's now on 171, 68 for Jonathan Trott. He's back in the runs, and every chance now of England getting well over 500, and that means the ball is starting to turn as well. So make no mistake about it, this dry, cracked, abrasive pitch, it's starting to turn, and so far England have out-bowled them, they've out-batted them, and they've out-fielded them. They've dropped a couple of catches as well, including Sharma this morning, a simple caught and bowled from Alistair Cook. But everything's going England's way, and there is a wicket, and Cook is out. I said the ball, oh no, that was the replay of how he got out in the first innings, in the first test match, but... Morgan on 47, Strauss on 37, Peterson failed yet again. He got a brave umpiring decision. It was out, although he didn't think it was. And in the end, it was Broad who was the final last man out, and 212, and a win by 78 with nearly seven overs to spare. That's quite a thrashing, and let's see what Andy Flower and Andrew Strauss can do for Saturday at Lord's.
Just quickly, would you rather England bowled second rather than first?
No,
the fact they've already won the series.
Yeah, they've got the belief that they chase better, and they do, providing that the top three do the business. Now, for me, Ian, there's a big query arising about the wicketkeeper, because he had a brilliant 2020 World Cup competition, but he's got no runs in this series at all. The extra pace and the different demands of 50-over cricket are starting to find him out, and he's got a big battle on his hands because Matty Prior is scoring hundreds of runs for Sussex in one-day cricket. So there's a query about him. Very nasty blow of just above the left eye through the helmet has been taken to hospital, strapped to an ambulance, so there's obviously possible complications. We can go no further than that, but it's a sad sight to see because Mushfiqur Rahim, one of the best players as a batsman, as a keeper in the Bangladesh side, and when he got that wicked ball that lifted from a length of almost from nowhere and turned and struck him above the left eyebrow, and it's obviously an eye injury that needs examining. So
over to the cricket and find out what's happening. Thank you, Jack Bannister.
Talk Sport at the Test update with Marston's Pedigree. England has it.
Well, good morning to the two Mikes, morning to all Radio Talk Sport listeners, because glorious day at Old Trafford. We've got the best test pitch in the country here. It's a pitch on which Steve Harmison has got alarming bounce over the last 3 or 4 years. It turns as well because it's hard, it's dry, and Monty Panesar's got 3 5-wicket hauls. He's not in this game, obviously, but even so, this will be a good contest. And remember, at Lord's, on a flat pitch in the entire match, Little Bangladesh scored 664 runs, and they lost with a session to spare. Another 40 runs from somewhere, and they'd have drawn that game. So they're not to be just dismissed right out of hand. Team news is, and the toss, England have won the toss, they're going to bat first. And the team news is that Ajmal Shahzad comes in for Tim Bresnan. Born in Yorkshire, and so one Yorkshireman replaces another. Bresnan injured, and Bangladesh not over pleased with some of their quick bowling at Lord's, have brought in an extra spinner, Abdul Razak. So Strauss and Cook will open the innings in about 8 or 9 minutes time. A reasonable crowd, and as you say, a new look Old Trafford with what they call the Point. It holds 1,000 people for conferences, and it's going to be used virtually every day of the year, and that's the way the game is going. So money rules, and England hope they'll rule today. They've won the toss, they'll bat. Play starts in 10 minutes time. Mike Hunt, the groundsman, he's done a very good job indeed. Dry on top, but there's moisture underneath.
Is Mike Hunt here? Mike Hunt here! Has anybody seen Mike Hunt?
Hey Frank, ask all the car hops if Mike Hunt's outside.
Telephone call for Mike Hunt. Is Mike Hunt in the parking lot?
Has got to be in these, particularly in these dry conditions, where the groundsman, Mike Hunt, has put enough moisture in to at least get the pitch staying reasonable until the third or fourth days.
Has anybody seen Mike Hunt?
Hey Frank, ask all the car hops if Mike Hunt's outside.
Telephone